the president of Montessori in 2002 years ago. Headmasters, headmistress, your parents, beloved teachers, the Sun Media, and my dear loving children. First of all, I wish all of you a happy Independence Day. All of you know, on 15th August 1947, India became a free nation. We have crossed 73 years of free life in independent India. We have achieved a lot of developments and progress in our nation. Every day, we are experiencing some or other kind of achievements in our nation. Recently, we have seen Chandrayaan 2, we have sent to sky or to the space. So it did not reach, in fact. So we are reaching lot of heights in our achievements. Our science and technology is growing very fast. Everywhere we are seeing developments. But my dear loving children, all these achievements we have acquired only because of the freedom of India. In 1947, our great leaders like Pandit Nehru, Gandhiji, Bhavaneshwar Gokhale and other leaders tried their level best to get freedom for India, and now we are all enjoying this freedom because of the struggle of these great leaders. While we are celebrating Independence Day, we have to remember the sacrifices made by these great leaders. So, I wish all of you a very happy Independence Day, and I remind you to uphold in the ideals of our father of the nation, Gandhiji, and the great leaders like Nehruji and others. Second point I would like to remind you, nowadays, our country, not only our country, throughout the world, we are experiencing lot of natural calamities. Natural calamities became an order of the day. You see, the third week of May, we have seen natural calamity in Orissa. First week of July, we have seen the biggest and deadliest flood in Assam. Again, we are seeing the flood in Maharashtra, Gujarat, Karnataka, and now we are experiencing in Kerala. It shows the nature is not in favor of us. Natural calamity means nature is not in our favor. Nature is against us. You should remember that nature is against us means we are hurting the feelings of nature. You and I, we the human beings are hurting the feelings of nature. So nature is getting angry on us and nature is working against us because of the torture we are putting upon the nature. What we have done all these 73 years or all these 100 years, we have been utilizing the natural resources without any control. We were cutting the forest, we were utilizing the storms, we are taking the sand from the river. So many things, what is hidden in the nature, we have been exploiting it for our benefit. Because of this, nature throughout the country is against us. It is a high time for us, each one of us, to think positively what best we can do to protect the nature. You have seen the flood in Assam is one of the biggest for the last 100 years in the history of India. The Brahmaputra was overflowing around 10 to 15 days. People living in the low-lying areas were not able to get their food in Assam area, because I have personally seen the feelings of people of Assam. It's a hilly state. More than Kerala, it is a hilly state. People are finding difficult to move one place to another place. So all these things are happening because of the nature. So if we do not protect the nature, nature also will not protect us. It is high time that we have to understand why the nature is against us, why the flood is coming, why the drought is coming, why the nature is against us.
Because something we have done against the nature. See, all these years we had lot of forest. I think only less than 20% of the land area of India we kept as forest. But all these areas, even 20% also, we are utilizing for our own needs. When we cut more and more trees, nature is against us. We are losing their health. You see, the animals are coming from the forest area and they are destroying human life in many districts or in many states in India. It is happening. Animal shelter is being destroyed. Animal shelter, the forest area is being destroyed by human beings. So my dear loving children, you may think what we can do. It is duty of each one of us to protect the nature. When we cut one tree for our own needs, the nature is crying. So we have to plant many number of trees to protect the nature. You see, the America or Australia or New Zealand or European countries, there the natural calamities are not that much severe like India, because they protect the nature more than human life. They protect the nature more than human life. So my dear children, we have to think how we can protect the nature. First thing, we have to plant many number of trees. Many number of trees we have to plant. When we plant more trees, nature will be happy. We will be getting more rain and there will be facilities for the water to go out. And one more thing, you see in Hyderabad or in Amman or all the throughout India, we have constructed so many apartments, so many houses. All these constructions are made by destroying the natural path of the water to go out. The natural way for the water to go out has been broken by the constructions. When all these constructions are made, water is not able to go outside freely. So water is lagging there, there is chance of earthquake, there is chance of flood. So we have to protect the nature. Whatever the nature was there, we have to protect it as it is. Then only nature will be happy on us. If the nature is against us, nobody can save us. If the nature is against us, I remind you once again, if the nature is against us, nobody can protect us. So you and I, we all together should try our level best to protect the nature. The first thing, we start planting at least 2-3 trees in our houses. You see, in our school campus, wherever chance is there, we are making plantation, we are making cultivation, and we plant more and more trees in order to protect the trees. Behind our school, backside of the school, in front of our school, wherever place is available, we are trying to plant more number of trees. If we plant more trees, nature will be enjoying, we'll be getting very good oxygen. We'll be getting very good oxygen. Nowadays, the pollution is also very high. Pollution is high because of the excess outcoming of carbon dioxide or the reduction of oxygen. So we have to generate more oxygen by cultivating more and more plants. You understand? So each day, each one of you should try at least to plant 3-4 plants in your houses. Wherever place is there, you plant one tree there, so that this tree will protect us. See, animals are coming from the forest to our places. You can see monkeys coming. Why they are coming out? Are they angry on us? Monkeys are coming to us. Why? They are angry on us. They don't have shelter in the forest. Monkeys do not have shelter in the forest. The forest is destroyed. So they are in search of place to stay. They are coming to our places. The animals are not getting food. They come to the open place where people are living, they are coming. In Assam, Kerala, Karnataka, West Bengal, all these areas where we have forest, animals are coming out and destroying the human cultivation because of the deforestation. So my dear students, my dear teachers, we should take it as a clear policy right from today. On this Independence Day, we have to make a clear decision that I will not destroy any plants. I will plant more and more number of trees wherever possible. Cultivation of plants will protect us, protect our nature, protect our human life. Another thing, all of you are carrying plastic bags with you. All these plastic bags will not be destroyed. You have to avoid the use of plastic everywhere. Wherever possible, we should use only cloth. We have to avoid use of plastics. If you avoid the use of plastic, not only you have to tell your father, mother, your non-people, we should not use plastic. Because this plastic cannot be destroyed. If plastic is kept somewhere, water will be flowing there and nature will be destroyed. Nature will be destroyed. So use of plastic is one of the reasons for this kind of calamities. So you have to stop the use of plastic and you have to plant more and more trees. How many of you will be planting more number of trees from today? Do you have enough place at home to plant more trees? Wherever place available, you have to see this, we are seeing this in front of school now, Kadapa stones. Even you can remove two or three stones at your home, the place where the stones are laid, you can remove two or three stones and you can cultivate and plant there. You will be getting oxygen, you will be getting wood shade, and the earth will be protected, nature will be protected. Most of the people, they are only thinking about the beauty. When we try for the beauty, we are losing the nature. So my dear loving children, beloved teachers, take positively. We have to protect our nature. If nature is happy, then only we can enjoy our independence. Otherwise, we will be depending on the nature. We have to depend on nature. Nature should be happy on us. So I wish all of you should understand this basic fact. Reduce the use of plastic. Cultivate more and more plants so that we will be getting a happy nature. Nature should be happy with us, then only we can be happy in our life. So I wish all of you to enjoy the Independence Day. Thank you all. God bless you. Thank you.